Thank you. So I'm going to present some recent work on coordinate descent for learning with sparse matrix regularization. So this is joint work with Miro Judith, Miaou, and Jérôme Malik. So we're looking at large-scale supervised learning problems. So we have a set of labeled training data, and we're trying to solve jointly k-tasks or k-problems by looking for a W matrix, a rectangular matrix, so that it minimizes a penalized empirical risk minimization objective. So on the one hand, we have the lambda omega of W, which is the regularization penalty, and then the empirical risk. So typical examples of this are multi-output regression, so where the output space is just R with power k, and multi-class classification, which is going to be the focus here for the sake of clarity. So we're looking at such situations where we have large number of features, so D is very large number of classes, and obviously a large number of examples. So a common regularization penalty that allows to scale to large supervised learning problems is the trace norm regularization penalty. So it's just an L1 norm on the singular value spectrum of the rectangular matrix W. Then we have a context optimization problem. So we could think that it's an easy problem to solve, even though it's a large scale problem. The issue is that even though we take a smooth loss function, such as the multinomial logistic loss on the right-hand side, we still have a non-smooth regularization penalty term on the left side. So we would like to solve this kind of problem. So what is the state-of-the-art approach? The state-of-the-art approach leverages this decomposition, and there are so-called composite minimization algorithms. So the most popular one is the so-called proximal gradient algorithm. So these are attractive algorithms when the so-called proximal operator is cheap to compute, such as the proximal operator for the L1 in the vector case for the L1 norm, which is just thresholding the vector entries. It's highly accurate and comes with finite sample accuracy guarantees. The major weakness of this kind of algorithms is then when the proximal operator is expensive to compute. And they're also quite sensitive to conditioning of the design matrix, which happens quite often in large-scale applications when we have a large number of features that are most often correlated. So the situation with the trace norm is the proximal operator in this case corresponds to performing a full singular value decomposition on the W matrix at each iteration. And this is extremely expensive in terms of running time, also in memory. So we're seeking a method that doesn't involve such highly expensive linear iterations. So what we propose is a coordinate descent approach. So in the vector case, for just a regular L1 norm, the coordinate descent algorithms provide efficient and scalable algorithms and large-scale algorithms. They're competitive with composite minimization algorithms, although they don't come with similar theoretical guarantees. And they're quite robust to ill-conditioned design matrices. Yes. The issue is that it's unclear how to devise such methods for trace norm regularization penalties, because we don't know which kind of coordinates we're going to choose to perform coordinate descent. So here, we use lifting into some infinite dimensional space to perform the coordinate descent. So instead of looking for using the singular value decomposition of W, which is obviously inaccessible because we don't know the solution, we just use decomposition of W onto rank one subspaces, which constitute an open complete dictionary. And then the trace norm can just be written as the minimal L1 norm or the weights of the decomposition of W onto those rank one subspaces. Now, fitting that into the original objective, we get the lifted objective, which looks very much like usual L1 regularized learning problems, where we have, in place of the the trace norm, we just have the sum of the weights of this decomposition onto the overcomplete dictionary. We can also show that if the loss function is convex and smooth, then the two problems are equivalent in the sense that even though the lifted objective is a convex measurement of the original problem, they share the same minimum. Now, the coordinate descent algorithm. So it works as follows. We have this decomposition onto the overcomplete dictionary, and at every iteration, we pick a coordinate that yields the steepest descent. Okay? And then, if we don't have a sufficient descent schedule, then we perform a subspace minimization. So let's take a closer look at each kind of iteration. So the picking the coordinate which yields the steepest descent corresponds to computing the top singular vectors of the gradient of the loss function. And this is linear in time in the dimension of the problem. The second step, which is the subspace minimization, can just be performed by using Newton's method, because so far we keep increasing the support of theta, and this is small, so we can perform a second order optimization. And when the support of theta becomes large, then we can perform more scalable approaches as quasi-Newton. So just a snapshot on our experiments. So we performed a comprehensive benchmark comparing the proximal gradient and our approach. This is just a picture on a favorable case. So we are in a extremely large scale situation, and the features are highly correlated, and our approach is quite competitive compared to proximal gradient approach, meaning that in terms of CPU time, it gives a higher accuracy than the proximal gradient in less time. So the take-home message of this work is that, so it's a well-known result that the trace norm is just an L1 norm in some high-dimensional space, yet we can use that and leverage that to design an efficient and fast algorithm for trace norm regularized learning problems that scale to large data sets. So please come to our poster and we'll be there for that.